Hi guys, ellarku vanakkam. Let's begin with the square root where we stopped in the last class. Okay, squaring a number is another mathematical operation just like addition, subtraction, multiplication. Okay, most mathematical operations have inverse meaning, opposite operations. For example, subtraction is the inverse of addition, right? Division is the inverse of multiplication, that also you know. Squaring also has an inverse operation, namely finding the square root. Okay, the square root of a number n is written as root n, okay, or n power 1 by 2 is the number that gives n when multiplied by itself, right? Like square root of 81 is 9. If 9 is multiplied with 9, you will get the same number, okay, which is under the root. Okay, in this adjacent table we have square roots of all the perfect squares starting from 1 to 100. Okay, root 1 is 1, okay, root 4 is 2, because see the reason, 2 square is 4, root 9 is 3, root 16 is 4, root 25 is 5, okay, root 36 is 6, root 49 is 7, root 64 is 8, root 81 is 9, root 100 is 10. Or go in the other way, 2 square is 4, square root of 4 is 2, 3 square is 9, square root of 9 is 3, like that, okay, right. If 11 square is 121, what is root 121? 11. If 529 is 23 square, what is the square root of 529? 23. Like 324, 18 square. We can immediately tell that root 324 is 18. Okay. We have 1 square is 1, so square root of 1 is 1. Similarly, minus 1 whole square is also 1. So minus 1 is also a square root of 1. Okay. So that is the reason why we indicate square root with plus or minus. Okay, so the above example holds good for any number, any perfect square number. Okay, but here in working out of the problems, we will take up only positive integral square root. The positive square root of a number is always denoted by symbol root, thus root 4 is 2 and not minus 2. Okay, we have to remember that this is universally accepted notation. Okay, a square root through prime factorization. Okay, there are methods to find the square roots. One of the method is prime factorization. What is prime factorization? If 6 is there, 6 can be written as 2 into 3, right? Okay, by factorizing with the prime numbers, 2 is a prime number, 3 is a prime number, like that. Okay, the square of the given numbers, 6 square is 36, right? So nothing but 2 2s are there, 3 3s are there. So 2 into 2, 3 into 3 can also be written as 2 into 3 whole square. So square root becomes 2 into 3, right? That is 6. Okay, so using prime factorization, your job will get easier, okay, while finding the square root. Fine. See, 1 is missing here, 144, this number is 144, okay. Look at 6, I told you one example, right? Other examples are not necessary, okay. They are also in the same way, right? So, it is trivial to discuss the other examples also. So, let's move on. The number of times of a prime factor occurs in the square number is the twice the number of times it occurs in the prime factorization of the number. Okay. Right. See here in the example, 6 it is 2 into 3. 36 it is 2 into 3 into 2 into 3. So 2 times it will appear. That is what he is saying. Okay. So we use this idea to find the square roots. Okay, group the identical factors and pairs and find the square root. Find the square root of 324. How to do prime factorization? This is the method. 324. How many times it will go with 2? 162. Okay. Again we go with 2. 81. It will not go with 2. So you have to take 3. add these two numbers. 8 plus 1 is 9. 9 is divisible by 3. That means it is divisible by 3. Okay. For 2, when the last number is even number, it will be divisible by 2. Okay. Like that you have to proceed. With 3 it is 27. Again add these two numbers. 2 plus 7 is 9. 9 will go with 3. So you can take 3. Again 3 9s. Again 3 3s. Okay. So how many 2s are there? How many 3s are there? 2 2s are there. 1 2 3 4. 4 3s are there. Okay. So 2 square into 3 square into 3 square or 2 into 3 into 3 all square. So root 324 is nothing but 2 into 3 into 3. How much it is? 18. Okay. Very simple method. Let's see another example. Find the least number by which 250 is to be multiplied or divided that the resulting number is a perfect square. Also find the square root in that case. Okay. 250, it will go by 2 also. You can start by proceeding with 2 because the last digit is even number. Okay. But he considered 5. Let him take 5. 550 is a 250. Again go with 5. 5 tens are 250. Sorry, 5 tens are 50. Again go with 5. 5 twos are 10. So 3 5s are there. 1 2 is there. So 5 square into 5 into 2. So these prime factors, they do not have pairs. Either you have to divide by 10 or multiply by 10. It will become perfect square. Okay, so there are two ways to get the perfect square. Either divided it by 10 or multiply it with 10. Okay, let's multiply it with 10. So this becomes 5 square into 5 square into 2 square. Okay, so the answer becomes 25 into 2, 50. Okay, the square becomes 2500, right? When you multiply 250 with 10, you will get 2500 eventually. Okay. So that is multiplication with the least number. Again division with the same number, you will end up getting 5 square, 25. Okay, 25 is a perfect square. Okay, root 25 is nothing but 5, right? 5 square, 25 can be written as 5 square, so nothing but 5. you got the idea. He is 108, the perfect square number. His resemblance is a perfect square number. Let's see. 108. It will go with, see, the last digit is 8, even number. So it will go with 2. 54. Again, it will go with 2. 27. It will not go with 2. Add these two numbers. Right. 9. 9 is divisible by 3. So this is divisible by 3. 3 9 is 27. 3 3 is this. So 2 2s are there. 3 3s are there. Okay. 1 3 is missing. Multiply with 1 3. You'll get a perfect square number. So this is not a perfect square number, that you can say by just factorizing the given number. See, this is what he's asking. If you want to make it a perfect square, what should you do? Okay, with which number, with smallest factor you have to multiply with 3 or divided by 3. Okay, that is the answer. Finding the square root of a number by long division method. There is one more method, long division method. Okay, by that method also you can find the square root. But let me say frankly, even though it seems very easier to find the square root using factorization method, it is tedious when the given digit has more number of digits. Got the point? So this is the best method to find the square root. Okay, so I recommend you to follow this method carefully. Let's say we are finding the square root of 576 by long division method. What is this method suggest? Write 576 like this. Okay, group the numbers in two in pairs. Okay, from the rightmost, from 6. Okay, two in pair. Again, this is left or right. So this will go by 2, right? 2 into 2, 4. Okay, 1 will remain. Thereafter, 76 has to come down. Okay, add these two, 4. So here you have to write 4. Okay, this is what I am telling. 2 plus 2. Okay, 4 you have to write. Again, let's see which digit will fit in here. Okay, 6 is there. So 2 is a 4, 3 3 is a 9, 4 4 is a 16. Let's write 4 then. 4 4 is a 16, 1 4 4 is a 16, 17. Yeah, it will come to this place. 4 4 4 44 is a 176. There is no remainder. That means it is a perfect square. If there is a remainder, that means it is not a perfect square. Okay, so 24 is the answer. Got the point? Okay. Now let's see some illustrations. Okay. This is the number. See how much big it is. If you keep on factorizing it, you will find the answer eventually, but it will take a huge amount of time. Fine. So again, we are grouping in two in numbers from rightmost. This is the rightmost part. Okay, 2 2 2. This will go with 5, right? 5 5 is a 25. You have to write the same number here and here. Okay, so that is the reason we are going with 5. Why? Because 4 4 is 16, 5 5 is a 25, 6 6 is the 36. 36 is more than 28, so you have to take 5 only. Okay, the closest number possible, that is less than the given pair of the numbers. Okay, then 3 will remain. 83 has to come down. 5 plus 5 is 10. Okay, so 10 has to come here, right? And then 3 is there. So which number you have to take? Let's say if you take 2, this becomes 204. If you take 3, this becomes 309. If you take 4, it will go beyond 383. That is the reason why we have to take 3 only. So 3 3 is a 9, 300, 3 1 is a 3, 309. 83 minus 309 is 74. Now this pair will go down. Okay, see the arrows clearly in each step, in every step. Okay, after the step, the remaining pair has to come down. Okay, the remaining pair of the numbers has to come down. Okay, now 103 plus 3, 106 will come here. Now see, 9 is there. So which number has to fit? 2 will not fit. 2 2 is a 4. So 3 will fit maybe, but that makes very less number. Okay, so again you have to end up getting 9 at the end. So which number you have to take? 4 will not fit. 4 4 is 16. 5 5 is 25. That also will not fit. 6 6 is 36. That also will not fit. 7, yes, 7 can fit. 7 7 is 49. Okay, 9 4, right? 7 0 0. So 7 6 is 42. 42 plus 4 6. 6 will come here. Okay, again 4 is remaining. This, since this is 0, 4 will come here. 7 7 7 on the 7s. So 7 into 1067 is nothing but 7469. So the remainder is 0. Okay, the remainder is 0. Fine. So 537 is the given answer, answer we got at the end. So square root of this number is 537. See how many steps it took? It took 6 steps only. In 6 steps you got the answer by using long division method. Okay, see, this is the another example. Okay, I recommend you to take one exercise problem and start doing it. Okay, it's very simple. Let's I will also do one for you. Okay, otherwise you'll be thinking that I am just giving the illustration of the examples given in the textbook. Fine. So this is 45. The pairing is done. 45 means which number you have to take? You have to take 6 only, because it is already there. No, not like that. 7 7 is 49 is more than 45, so you have to take 6 only. 6 6 is 36. 9 will come down. 96 will come down. Okay, 6 plus 6 is 12 here. Okay, which number will go? 7 he took, right? 7 will go. If you take 8, it may be beyond 996. That is the reason why he took 7.
So this is 889.
So 107, 84 will go. Now last digit is 4. 2 will not fit because it is too small, small number. 5 digits are there, right? So 8 you have to take. Okay. Then this answer you will get, the remainder is 0. So answer is 678. Okay. Yeah, it is very simple when you, when we solve what examples. 400 is not a perfect square, man. No, it is perfect square. Long division method, 20 is the answer anyway, but I have to illustrate the method, right? Right. So what should I do? I need some tools, right? What tools I need? I also need to draw like this, right? This is one line, right? So I'm drawing a perfect straight lines in this way. Fine. Okay. Oh, so I'm taking a bigger number in white color. Well, like, but that color won't work. I need karup color. Vannam, not annam, this is vannam. This is also still bigger. We don't need this much big numbers while solving problems. That is fine. Okay, again you think it is big. Okay, let me reduce it for you. Okay, standard 1200, right? Okay, next 4. What is the number? 00 00. You want a space? Okay, let's have a space. 400. Fine. Okay. No, not here. Here you have to write. Okay, fine. So 00 has to be in pair, right? So reduce that size. Fine. This became a pair. Okay, I am not drawing that line. Okay, anyway, for me it is became habitual to take in pairs. Okay, I have been doing it, right? So which one I have to take? That is straightforward. 4 means 2 into 2 is 4, right? 2 here, another 2 on the top. Okay, down, fine. Now 2 2's how much? 4. So there is no remainder here. Remainder is 0. This is 0. 2 00. Fine. So 2 plus 2 is 4 will come down. 4 has to come down. 2 plus 2 here. But here zeros have to come down. 1 0 here, 2 0s here. Okay, fine. This 4 has to go like this. Okay, there should be some space to write, right? So zeros, all zeros, we have to stop it here. No, why? Again you have to take one more zero, right? Here also you have to take one more zero. Fine. So 0 0 0 0. Two zeros only. Okay. You will get on the multiplication, you will get 2 zeros. Okay. So the remainder is 1 0. So all zero problems we got. So answer is 20. Okay. Why 2 cannot be the answer? Because see, one more thing is left, right? This has to come down. Okay, that in the long division process, no number should be left like this. Okay, even though they are zeros. okay, that is the important point. I can do one more examples for you. 1764 also I can take, but let me see, can I get enough amount of space here for drawing these straight lines? I got the space, somehow I managed to get fine. So what to take here? 1764, okay, 17, I'm taking in pairs, right? That's why I'm making it like this. Okay, if you're habituated to take that part, which part? Not that part. That this line. Okay, you can, your wish, if you want you can take it. Okay, anyway that is not required for me as of now. Why? Because I was habituated to do this, right? These kind of things right from the childhood, right? Why this line is not coming? Straight line? No. This time this is cheated me. Oh, let us extend up to here. Okay. Now 17 means 4 is 16. You got that point? Let us extend this also. Okay. 4 is 16. So you have to write 4. 4. No. Okay, that is not listening, that's why I'm saying. Okay, 4 again here, 4. Okay, how much it is? 4 is 16. Remainder is 1. Okay, let us write 1 at the bottom. Okay, this arrow thing, that also I need to draw. Come down, no, like this. So that is not straight. Like this, this is also not straight. Like this, somehow is unable to draw straight line. Yeah, now I got it. Hey. No? Let's delete this straight line. This I am not needing right now. Okay. Okay. Okay, this is quite big enough. Yes, it is quite big enough. Is that fine? Yeah, that is fine. Okay. No, not like that. It has to go like this. Fine. Reduce a bit. Yes. Okay. Not straight. Let us leave it like that. Why? Because we are running out of time, right? Time is precious. We are running out of time. That is the reason I left that arrow. Okay, 4 plus 4 is 8. So here you have to write 8 first. Okay. How much I have to write here? 2 is fine. 2 2 is a 4. 2 8 is 16. Yes. That will serve my job. I don't need this space. Okay. Fine. Okay, let me take it later. 2 I have to write here also. Where? Here. Not there. Here. Okay. What will come? This went there. So 2 2 is a 4. 4. 2 8 is a 16. 4. 2 8 is a 16. 6. So 64 will go here. Yay! Where you went? Where you went? Where you went? I need you. Okay. 1. Okay. That's it. 2 to the 4, 2 8 is 16. Okay. We are following his way of his style of writing. Oh, you want it more thick? Let it be. So the answer is 0. Again, I have to sing or what? No, I got it without singing. Fine, that's best. That's best. No, I need not increase the size. Okay, 0. 0. So what is the answer? 42 is the answer. Okay, 42 is 1764. Is that correct? I think so. Is that correct? Is that correct? Again, you can ask me that question. 42 is, let's multiply 42 into 42. Let's see whether it is correct or not. Fine. 42 is 40 plus 2 whole square of 1600 plus 4. Okay. Plus 80. See, 160. 1600 plus 160, 1760. Yeah, that is correct. Okay. So, similarly, you can proceed with the third one which I left. Okay. So, number of digits in the square root of a perfect square number. We made use of bars to find the square root of division method. This marking bar will help us to find the number of digits in the square root of a perfect square number. Observe the following example. So, these marking bars will help you to find the square root division. Okay. That is what they are doing. 169 square root is 13, 441 21, this is 112. Okay, number of bars are 2. Here the number of bars are again 2. Okay, so number of digits in the square root 2. Number of digits in the square root 2. Here it is 3. Here the number of bars are 3. 1, 2, 3, like that. Okay, so number of bars has a direct correlation with the number of digits in the square root. We conclude that the number of bars indicate the number of digits in the square root. Fine. So that is what I didn't mention here. 400. Okay. Two bars are there. So two digits must be there in the square root. You got the point? Yes, you got the point. I know now. Without calculating the square root, guess the number of digits in the square root of the following numbers. Put the bars and tell 1, 2, 3, 3. Here 1, 2, 3, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5. Okay. Square root of decimal numbers. To compute the square root of decimal number in the decimal form, we simply follow the following steps. You observe this. Am I going fast? Yes, we are running out of time. So what must we do? We will stop it here, otherwise I will go a little fast and you will not catch up the bus. Okay, so let's stop it at 1.7.4 square root of decimal numbers. Thank you. See how beautiful this nature is. You also start planting the trees. Let us bring a new change in our society. Let us plant the trees and let others plant the trees. Let's take this pledge seriously from now. Thank you.